Come in. Make yourself at home. Look around.
I'm just a little concerned about my brother, that's all.
By the end of the day, I should have something.
Really? You mean there's been a breakthrough?
I've been studying the information on this Green Meadows spa.
Oh?
I'm hoping by the end of the day we have our murderer behind bars. The way I see it here, there's something rotten in Green Meadows.
Oh?
Listen, I can't go into anything. Sorry.
Is it better for Decker?
Hopefully it is, yeah.
Yeah, well, no details at all, huh?
I can't.
Well, what was on the tapes? I mean, I could tell...
Come in!
See you later?
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, you better have a damn good reason for keeping me here.
Well, how does a matter of life and death grab you?
You already asked. I already told you. I don't know anything about a videotape with Ned Ashton and Monica Quatermain. I never even employed a Ned Ashton.
It says here a man named Ward was terminated for immoral conduct. Think you could tell me about that?
I expected my employees to conduct themselves appropriately. If they didn't, they were fired. They were terminated.
Mm-hmm. Well, from the looks of those tapes, you must have terminated a hell of a lot of employees, huh?
Those tapes were made for security purposes.
Security?
Yes, in case there were legal problems with jealous husbands, trapped wives, whatever.
But it had nothing to do with blackmail, of course.
I won't even dignify that with an answer.
Well, then I'm going to keep asking until you do. You were blackmailing your clients, weren't you, Miss Shelby?
No.
I think you better think a little harder. This is Wendy Masters' book. Recognize the names?
That doesn't prove a thing.
Well, think again. I've got this ledger, I've got bank statements, and I've got these tapes. You know what I think, lady? I think Wendy Masters was blackmailing Monica and Ned to pay off you and your friend Clayton. And she was keeping a little stash on the side for herself, so you had her put away.
I didn't murder Wendy. I swear I didn't do it.
The question's blackmail. Did you blackmail Wendy Masters?
No. Well, yes, but it was Clayton's idea. He insisted that he forced
me. Now we've moved on to murder. Where were you at 2 a.m. that morning?
My hotel room.
Anybody see you?
Oh, the room service waiter.
We can check that out.
If I were you, I'd concentrate on the other names in Wendy's book.
Anybody that doesn't have an alibi is a suspect. And you're number one right now, baby. Hey, Rube.
Hi, darling.
Listen, Felicia called me from the brownstone. She's home wilting.
Oh, poor baby.
Yeah, you got anything nice and cool that I can bring over to her?
Well, how about a quart of fresh strawberry ice cream, icy cold?
Oh. Actually, I might have a little of that. Why don't you give her the chilled fruit, though?
Oh.
Hmm?
Oh, that's mean. Okay,
great, thanks. I'm in a bit of a hurry.
All right, girl.
Okay.
Here, thank you. I'll get it for you.
Good. Hey.
So, how did it go with Gloria?
Didn't turn out the way I planned. She came up with an alibi.
That's great. What's her alibi?
Room service waiter delivered her room service at the time of the murder.
So, you writing her off, or what?
I gotta talk to the waiter first. I know it doesn't look good for your brother.
Yeah, I was just, thinking about Carla, actually, Frankie's sister.
What about her?
Well, she came by headquarters just about the time that you were, talking to Gloria. She said that she was concerned about me. She just wanted to see how I was doing. I said, that's the excuse she gave, anyway.
Why do you think it was an excuse?
Why would she come all the way down to police headquarters, make herself late to work just to see how...
Well, she probably knows how worried you are. Maybe she was being supportive. She has her reasons.
I don't buy it.
Listen, you put up bail for a brother, right? I mean, that's a pretty big reason if you ask me. You've done a lot for her. Hmm?
Maybe you're right.
Well, if the situation were reversed, what would you do?
Yeah. Well, maybe I'm just being paranoid, huh?
Yes, sir. I brought an order to Miss Shelby's room that night. It's right there, the exact time I delivered it.
You sure this time is accurate?
Oh, yes. It's our policy to keep very careful time records in order to provide a good service.
Mm-hmm. All right, that'll do. Thank you for your cooperation.
You're welcome.
Hey, one more thing. It seems rather strange that she would order champagne and caviar for one. Did you ever wait on her before, or anybody else that you know waited on her?
It's funny you should ask that.
Why?
Well, it's just that she tried really hard to keep me from seeing who was in there with her, but I got a glimpse, and it was a guy.
Was it him?
Yeah, that's him.
You're positive?
Absolutely.
Thank you. If I need you again, I'll be in touch. That was the waiter from the hotel.
You got Gloria's alibi.
So yeah, what? It's good. He saw her there that night. He waited on her. Clayton was there with her.
Right, so that's that, huh?
You can release Miss Shelby. Tell her not to leave Port Charles.
Got it.
Thank you. According to the waiter, they were there together. He brought him some food. Drink.
Well, that's great. So that just leaves Monica and Ned.
And Decker.
Look, Frisco, damn it, I know Decker didn't do this. I don't care how it looks. Look, she could have paid off that waiter, right?
Colton, relax. I'll take you to Kelly's and have a beer.
Yeah, right. I'll see you later.
I don't know what else to tell you, but I think her alibi sticks.
All right, I got the point. It's, she's off the hook, right?
Well, as much as I don't like to think it, I don't believe that Clayton or Gloria did it.
So, Decker becomes the number one suspect by default. Any idea when you plan to let Ned
off? Nothing is by default, I promise you.
Really?
Look, I also haven't told you one other thing here. I found out that Decker was at Green Meadows Health Spa a few months ago, too.
Really? Wow, well, he must have done it then, huh? I am so sick of the way you are manufacturing this case against Decker.
Hey,
look, what about the other suspects? You can just let them...
All the evidence points right to your brother. I'm just stating the facts.
All the evidence, huh? Such crap.
Did you ever think...
You made up you've hung him already.
That your brother might have played us all for suckers?
If anybody's been set up, it's Decker.
And don't you think I'd like to believe that?
No, I think you would like for this case to be over with. Whatever's convenient, Frisco. You know, you can pin the murder on him, the stabbing on me, anything that's in
just
the unsolved
files. What do you want
files.
From me?
I want you to do your job.
Listen. All the evidence points right to your brother, and you know it. And we're not even bringing up the fact that your brother wrote a note to Wendy saying, meet me at the carousel.
Could have been a forgery. Did you ever think of that?
I had it checked out with forensics. It's not.